This week on the Shtick, we have with us as our special guest, Judith Field. I'm going to ask Judith, what's your shtick?
My shtick is communication. I help people communicate more confidently, and I just love doing it.
Well, I'll let you talk, and I'll just keep quiet. Is that communicating?
It can be, because what you'll be doing, if I'm really communicating with you well, is nodding your head and smiling and leaning forward a bit or just doing some sort of movement. Because one of the things I say about speaking, public speaking particularly, it's not just standing up and talking. And in fact, the words, Henry, are the least of it. Our body language says the most, our vocal variety says the second most, and the words are actually the least. So that when we communicate, we want to look at people, we want to smile, and see how you're nodding your head back, and that is communicating.
And so I'm acknowledging your
absolutely.
Speech.
And people say when they get up to speak that they don't like people looking at them, and I say, but you do want them to look at you, because you want to be able to communicate. And earlier in the show, they talked about head and heart, and that's what it's about. It's taking stuff from your head that you really want to say, just getting to the essence of it. But also, when you speak, you want some of your feelings in it and connecting with your audience. That's really what it's about, and keeping it simple.
And not talking too much.
And not talking too much.
Because that can be a problem, because I know some people who just talk and you can't get a word in edgewise. And that can be a problem because the other person's just trying to get something somewhere and the other person's just yabba, 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 you know? And then they say,
absolutely.
You know, like this, and there's all these kinds of problems there are in speech. But basically, you teach more than anything else. You teach public speaking. You have a unique technique.
The uniqueness of it is that I talk to the voice in the head, the one that says, gee, this is really scary, or I'd rather die than speak, which is really sad. And so I shift that voice, and I use a lot of humour, a lot of toys, and just break it up into little bits so that people can just say a sentence, and they can just talk from their own experience and tell stories, because we all love stories. And I think a lot of people turn public speaking into something that's very serious. And when you speak, you want to keep it simple. You want to let your personality come up and just connect with whoever you're talking to.
And bring some humour or lightness into it. It's very important, isn't it? Because if you're too grave, everyone just shuts up. It just becomes too serious.
And anything, almost anything, can be made humorously. You know that the film Look Both Ways? I think one of the reasons it's a success is because there's all these funny moments about death. And, you know, when he says, I've got to leave you because I've got cancer, she says, hey, 1 minute, I should be leaving you. Like, you know, it's the humour in the moment. And then he's just been diagnosed with cancer, and she says to him, oh, I think you're going to ask me my star sign at, like, cancer. And he goes, cancer, like she knows I've got cancer. So the humour is,
yes.
And I used to take myself far too seriously. I have to admit it. And now I know that when you laugh at yourself and at life, it just lightens everything up.
So confidence is very important.
It's 80% of it, and the rest is skill.
And knowing what you're talking about. I think a lot of it is, I mean, a lot of people speak and they really don't know what they're talking about for the sake of talking.
Yeah, and structure is the other very important thing, just making it clear and signalling what you're saying and saying.
In point form, you have points and then you say, okay, this is the point, and then you follow up each point and then you get to some sort of a conclusion where at the end you're making sense of everything that you've said.
Very accurate.
Thank you. What else can I ask you?
I think that one thing is that people think that public speaking is then that formal situation. I like to think that every form of communication is public speaking. And that people need to go to the essence of what they want to say and then find out if people want more, like ask more questions and listening.
Even on a one-to-one, especially.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think a sign of one of the things I've learned in life myself is a sign of intelligence is asking questions.
I'd like to add something there, because my daughter, Gabby Sar Shalom, who some of your audience might know.
She's been on the Shtick.
Well, Gabby says that the quality of your life is directly proportional to the quality of the questions that you ask yourself and others. And I think that's brilliant. And I think that the more, you know, when you go to a party and you don't know what to do, just ask someone questions. Just ask questions. Not prying, but just open questions. And it's amazing how much you find out. Just, I've got to tell a quick story. I met someone at a party and I did nothing but ask them questions. And after 20 minutes, he said, well, I'll go and get a drink. It's nice to meet you. You're one of the most interesting people I've ever met. And I hardly said three words.
I think that's part of being a interviewer, isn't it? Is just letting the flow go by asking the relevant questions.
We've done that today.
We've done it really well. I think it's extremely important to communicate, whether it be through one-to-one, in public, on the internet, telephone.
Well, yeah, the interesting thing,
a whole subject. We might even go there.
Like when you're on the phone, just to smile when you're talking and, again, just keep it simple. People can talk for hours. They don't need to.
And so much trivia going on around the world, isn't there? It's very important to keep to the real important issues. And it's not so much the answer as it is the question.
I totally agree.
Totally. Judith Field, it's been an absolute pleasure to have you on the show. Communication is what it's all about. We're trying to communicate to our audience all the time about
life.
Life and the important issues, and especially with the shtick, we do some Jewish stuff. But we're also covering the world at large and all the issues that are pervading our planet at the moment.
Could I just finish with my three sayings? Because I love what I finish most of my workshops with, which is always say what you mean what you say, and this is the one I really love, never be mean when you say it. Because I believe everything can be said gently and with thought.
And generosity.
And feeling. And generosity. Give.
Of spirit.
Absolutely.
And what I love most about you, Judith? Purple. I've gone totally purple today.
We have.
It is a spiritual colour, and I think that the communication in spirit is what it's all about. We're winding up now. Back to the audience.
Hello, it's Bubba Helen here. And I'm reading the paper, not very nice of me, but I just want to say hello to all the lovely Shtick viewers that watch us without fail every week, and to communicate to you, which is today the theme of our show, communication, that it is very important to be a good communicator. You heard it from a lot of people today, from the rabbi especially. He's a wonderful communicator, and he knows what he's talking about, and also he knows what the people want to hear. And that's what I want to talk about today. You should really, when you are talking to other people. Once upon a time, we couldn't communicate at all. What did we know? We were monkeys. We were dragging our knuckles on the ground, as they say. And we didn't know nothing. Today, we've got a computer. We've got media. We've got Skype. We've got all kinds of wonderful things that you can use. It's no excuse for not communicating. But really, the basis of good communication is talking. Talking, listening. Talking and listening, if you are talking and listening, you are communicating. And if you are reflecting on what the other person is saying to you, then you are a good communicator. That's all you need to do, is listen, hear out, see, listen good, and then give back your answer. But reflect, first of all, what you're going to say. And if you've got nothing nice to say, say nothing at all. Have a wonderful week, and be a good communicator. Seid gesund.